Zoo, and today we're going to be talking about these big guys back here, I should say girls, our Burmese pythons. Now we have two Burmese pythons here at the zoo on exhibit. This is Sunshine and Spot. You can always tell them apart because Sunshine's got a much brighter yellow color and Spot is kind of the darker browns that are the more native or normal colors of the Burmese pythons. We also have a third Burmese python here at the Utica Zoo named Ira. You may have seen him out and about on Zoomobiles. He's actually gotten to be quite large now, so he only really comes out for special programs, and we have a lot of assistance when we take him out because we need more than one keeper or more than one educator when we bring him around. Now, Burmese pythons are a really hot topic in our country, specifically in Florida, because Burmese pythons down in Florida are what we call an invasive species. Now, an invasive species is an animal that is not native to that area, so the Burmese pythons are actually native to Asia that is introduced to an area like Florida where they do not originally exist or do not originally belong. And this can cause a lot of problems because a lot of the times if a non-native species or invasive species gets released into the wild, they can cause disruptions to the ecosystem, especially the food web. And in the case of the Burmese pythons, because they are such a large predator, the biggest problems that they're causing is they're eating a lot of the native wildlife, and there's not really any predator that goes after them that's big enough to really mess with the Burmese pythons. They're causing a lot of problems for those animals. Some of those animals are actually declining. It can cause an animal to become endangered, or sometimes even an animal to become extinct if an animal is getting eaten by a non-native species. Sometimes it's also a problem the other way around. So if it's an invasive species that might not be a predator, that might be something like a rabbit, for example, these guys will eat a lot of the native grasses and things and roots and cause a lot of problems for the way that the landscape grows or the way that the plants grow, make a lot of less resources available for some other species, some other animals. And that's actually a problem that they had down in Australia for a long time with the rabbits as well, and they still have today. So invasive species definitely aren't a good thing. Now, people think that the reason why Burmese pythons got so prevalent down in Florida is because people were keeping these guys as pets. Now, when you buy a snake as a pet, they're usually pretty young. They're very, very small. Sometimes people weren't aware that Burmese pythons got to be quite as big as they are. Burmese pythons are actually the third largest species of snake in the world. And these guys can grow to be about the size of a school bus. So they can get pretty large, pretty long in size. So it's really important when you get a pet that you know exactly what you're getting into, because sometimes if they get too big and you can't care for them, that can be a big problem. And there might, you might not be able to find a place that will be able to take care of them and care for them the way that you know, a zoo does. And the other thing too about these guys is that because they get so large, they're very, very smart animals, they're very tricky, and people would actually try to build their own homes or exhibits for these animals in their homes, and a lot of the times these guys would escape. So people thought that probably they were getting released purposefully into the wild because people couldn't care for them anymore, and that they were escaping from people's homes. And for that reason, you can no longer keep a Burmese python as a pet in most places in our country and in other places in the world as well. So it's just something important to remember if you're ever picking out a reptile as a pet, to do your research as far as how big they get, what they need, what the foods they eat, things like that, because reptiles can be very specific, especially when it comes to temperature and diet as well. Thank you guys so much for joining us here at the Utica Zoo, and we hope that you enjoyed our visit with our Burmese pythons. Be sure to check out our website at uticazoo.org/kazoo for some cool and really interesting facts about invasive species and endangered species, some activities for you guys to do at home. Thanks so much.